This is the temporal bone of the right side. The temporal bone has five parts: the squamous part, tympanic part, mastoid part, styloid part, and the petrous part. Now, the squamous part. The squamous part has two surfaces: external surface, internal surface. Two borders: superior border, anterior border. Superior border articulates with the parietal bone, anterior border articulates with the greater wing of sphenoid. Now, on the external surface, we have the zygomatic process. The zygomatic process has a post-glenoid tubercle and an articular tubercle. The zygomatic process gives origin to the masseter muscle. We have a supramastoid crest, supramedial triangle, external auditory meatus, grooves for temporal artery. On the internal surface, lodges the temporal lobe of the cerebral hemisphere, impressions for sulci gyri, meningeal vessel grooves, and we have a squamopetrous fissure. This is the mastoid part. The mastoid part has two surfaces, external surface and the internal surface. On the external surface, we have the mastoid process, the mastoid notch, and the groove for occipital artery. This is the mastoid foramen, from where a small branch of occipital artery passes. Now, coming on to the internal surface, this is the sigmoid sulcus, which lodges the sigmoid sinus. Third process, and the foramen present in between the styloid process and the mastoid process is the stylomastoid foramen, from where the facial nerve passes. The tympanic part has, this is the squamotympanic suture, and this is the tympanomastoid suture. It forms a part of the mandibular fossa, also called as the glenoid fossa. Now, coming on to the petrous part. The petrous part has three surfaces: anterior, posterior, and the inferior. On the anterior surface, we have impression, trigeminal impression, which lodges the trigeminal ganglion, arcuate eminence, and grooves for sulci and gyri. On the inferior surface of the petrous part, on the posterior surface, we have the internal auditory meatus, from where the 7th and 8th cranial nerve passes. On the inferior surface, we have the carotid sulcus, from where the internal carotid artery passes, and the jugular fossa, which, when on articulation with the occipital bone, forms the jugular foramen.